In this video, we'll cover everything you need to know about automations in Gymdesk. This is a powerful feature you can use to nurture leads, retain existing members, win back members who have canceled their membership, and more. You can access the automations from the Marketing tab by clicking on Automations from the sub-navigation. On this page, you'll see any existing automations you've already set up, their current status, and how many people have gone through the automations. To create a new automation, click Create Automation. Start by giving your automation a name at the top. Next, you'll need to decide what action or status causes someone to enter an automation. This is called an automation trigger. A few of these triggers have extra options. The options you have are member signup, visitor signup, new lead, membership start, promotion, absence, member frozen, member canceled, booking no-show, and manually trigger. For new lead, you can select a specific lead source. For membership start, you can select one or multiple membership types. For absence automations, you can select from trial memberships or regular memberships. For booking no-show, you can select one or multiple classes from your schedule. All of these triggers will automatically start the automation for contacts that meet the selected criteria, except for the manually triggered trigger option. The manually triggered option allows you to create automations that you assign manually to members or leads, but that do not start automatically. You can add contacts to automations manually from the members and lead lists and directly from a user's profile. Next, you can decide whether you want this automation to stop any or all previous automations that the contact is currently in. If you select no, this automation will run concurrently with other automation flows that the user is in. Next, you can select an optional exit trigger. You can select from started a membership, booked a class, canceled a membership, or a reply is received. For your automation steps, you can select from messages, flows, and actions, and you can drag and drop these steps to your automation in any order you like. Messages are communications you send to a member or lead. You can send email, SMS, or push notifications and fully customize the content of the message. Flows are used to determine how users move through an automation. Delay allows you to set a time delay for a specific period of minutes, hours, days, weeks, months, or sessions. It's important to note that if you don't set a delay within your automation between steps, your automation steps will occur immediately. Split allows you to divert contacts within automations into different sequences, based on if they've met one of the following conditions: booked a session, has a membership, canceled membership, replied to automation, or has tag. For booked a session, you can select from a specific scheduler session or any session. For has membership, you can select any membership or select a specific membership type. For canceled membership, you can select any membership or select a specific membership type. You can add as many splits as you like into an automation to further segment contacts into customized paths based on their behavior. Finally, you can chain multiple automations together by adding an existing automation into a new automation. Actions are changes you make to information within Gymdesk or other systems that you have integrated with your Gymdesk account. In Change Contact, you can add or remove custom tags that can be used to segment users within an automation. You can also change a member or lead status or change the contact type. In Create Task, you can assign a task to yourself or any of your staff with a due date. If you have external software integrated with Gymdesk, you can use webhooks to send and change information in that system automatically. For example, if you're using a CRM that supports webhooks, you can use this to update a contact's information to your external CRM. Once you've built and activated an automation, you can see stats for each level of the automation by clicking on Show Stats in the top left corner. To give you an idea of what's possible with automations, let's go through some potential automation flows for your gym, starting with the member win-back automation. This automation follows up with members who have canceled their membership. Any canceled member who becomes an active member again will exit this automation. Once a member has canceled their membership, we wait for 3 months to send them an email. After 2 more weeks, we send any contact who didn't reply to our first email another email to ask for feedback. After 2 more weeks, we send a promotional offer to anyone who hasn't replied to our emails. The objective of this next automation is to convert a lead into a member. This automation is triggered when a new lead is created. Contacts leave the automation if they sign up for a membership. When a new lead comes into our system, we immediately send a welcome email asking them how we can help them achieve their fitness goals. If they reply, they leave the automation. After 2 days, we send them another email asking them to sign up for a trial membership. After 2 more days, we send them an offer for a discounted membership. If they still haven't responded to our messages, we create a task for one of our staff members to follow up with them via phone. After 3 days, the status of leads who didn't respond to our phone call is automatically changed to cold lead. Up next is an automation to encourage contacts with a free trial to book a session at our gym. They enter the automation once they sign up for a trial membership and immediately receive a welcome email. After 1 day, we send them an email to give them more information about the gym and encourage them to book a session. We continue this sequence of encouraging them to book a session, and for any users who book, they receive a follow-up email and exit the automation. If they haven't booked a session or responded to any of our emails at the end of their trial, we change their status to cold lead. If a trial member replies to our final email, we'll create a task to extend their trial. Our final automation is for members who have been promoted within our gym. Any reply to this automation will cause them to exit. After they receive a promotion, they immediately receive a text to congratulate them along with a 25% discount offer for our store. We wait 3 days, then send them another reminder. These are just a few of the ways automations can save you time and help you streamline your gym marketing and management. Coming soon, we'll have a Gymdesk automations library with pre-built automations you can add to your account. Until next time, keep growing.